name is Lance, and I will be guiding you through a yin yoga practice for the next 60 minutes. Let's begin sitting on a comfortable seat. And I recommend sitting on a yoga block instead of the traditional cross-legged yoga posture, which you're all welcome to do. I'm going to sit in a different pose. It's called Virasana. So I'm sitting on a block in this position. You can sit on two blocks. I've got it between my ankles, so they're outside of my hips. And this way I can sit up tall. It doesn't matter how you sit, as long as your seat is comfortable and steady. Now, the practice of yin yoga supplements your regular yoga practice. We will gently stress the connective tissue around our joints, particularly the deep fascia around our muscles. And we'll do it in a manner that will slowly, over time, increase the range of motion and giving us more flexibility. There are three principles of yin yoga that are important to remember. Number one is the stretching sensation should only be gentle to moderate, never strong or painful. Less is more in yin yoga. The second principle is to hold the poses in stillness, using your breath, not the strength of your muscles, to relax. So we're not pulling ourselves into a shape, we're sort of melting into it with a long, slow exhalation. Now, it's okay to move for the first 30 seconds of our poses because you have to find that perfect stretch. So feel free to wiggle around until you settle into stillness. The third principle is that we hold the poses for a long time. In yin yoga, it's 1 to 5 minutes. We'll be going up to 3 minutes today. Now, I've come up with a fourth principle, and that's to let nothing float. So we want to put something between our body and the earth. We'll use lots of blocks, yoga blankets, pillows, bolsters if you have them. And that way we cannot sink deeper into the poses. And all we can do is relax and make the stretching sensation disappear. So now we're ready to move into our first yoga posture. I'll get my timer ready. It's going to be the supine heart opener, and we can practice applying these four principles. We're going to lay on our back on something firm that supports our entire back. I've rolled up two stiff yoga blankets. You can use a foam roller or a bolster, or you can just lay on your back. You can always improvise if you don't have all the tools. There's about a fist distance between my hips and my back support. I've got two blocks down by my knees. I'm going to roll back and settle into my back support. First thing I want to do is prop up my head here. And I want my neck to be completely relaxed. We're not working the neck, so it's got to completely relax. Notice that we're tilting our pelvis forward. There's a big tunnel under our lower back. So we're working on stretching that area of the pelvis, that tilt forward, a little more than we normally have. We're going to bring the soles of our feet together. Allow the knees to fall out to some blocks. Remember, we don't let anything float in the air. And feel the stretching sensation on the inner thighs. And finally, we're going to allow the elbows and the forearms to fall off to the side with the palms up, very relaxed. We're stretching the pectoral muscles and the front of our shoulders, the anterior deltoids. Make sure your neck is completely relaxed. We're only noticing a sensation in three parts of the body: inner thighs, lower back, forward tilt of the pelvis, chest, and fronts of the shoulders. Let's see if we can relax so much using our breath that stretching sensation will reduce or disappear. We're going to hold the pose for 2.5 minutes. Use your breath to relax, that focusing on the long, slow exhalation. And as I mentioned, you can wiggle around until you get right into the perfect pose and let it all go. Remain in stillness. Take an inventory of your body. Think about those areas we were stressing and stretching. Has the sensation disappeared or has it lessened? You know you're doing yin yoga well when you almost fall asleep in the poses. We don't want to notice any parts of the body at the end of our long-held poses. Let's move out of this pose very gently, bringing the knees together, and then we'll roll off to one side and remain there on our side with our back rounded, and we'll breathe deeply and exhale into that rounded back. So we've tilted our pelvis forward, and this is a counter pose. The spine is now bent in the opposite direction, in a very gentle manner. Let's come up to hands and knees, clearing our back support from the mat, getting ready to move to our second pose. From hands and knees, we'll do another counter pose, cat and cow. So let's inhale, dropping the belly, tilting the pelvis forward. This should feel good because this is the way our pelvis was tilted in the supine heart opener. Now exhale very gently and carefully, rounding the back, moving the spine in the opposite direction. Inhale into the cow, and carefully, mindfully exhale into the cat pose. Sit the hips back on the heels, stretch the arms forward, and come into child's pose. So is anything floating? Is there space between your heels and your hips? If there is, put something. Is there space between your forehead and the mat? If so, put something there. And take 3 deep breaths. And then come up to hands and knees. Our next pose is melting heart. We're going to work on stretching the fronts of the shoulders. And we're going to keep doing that forward tilt of the pelvis. We're going to keep our hips right over our knees, and we're going to bring our chest down to something. Or it can be the lower ribs, as you like. Reach the arms forward, straight arms, and melt the heart down to that support. You can use one or two blocks in any position. Don't make the stretch too strong. Now, since we're stretching the front parts of the shoulder, if you're really comfortable here with straight arms, you can increase that stretch by putting some blocks in the low position under your forearms. This is an advanced variation, so don't go here if you're not ready for it. So here we are in the melting heart pose, stretching our fronts of our shoulders primarily, and also a forward tilt of the pelvis. Let's hold this pose just for 2 minutes, and then we're going to do another interesting variation of the pose. Use your breath to relax. Settle into the earth. Remaining in stillness, note the quality of the stretch in the shoulders. Hopefully it's disappeared. If it's increased, maybe you've reached too far and you can use more support so the stretch is not quite so strenuous. Let's come back up, hands and knees, and sit back into child's pose. And then we'll bring our arms back by our feet with the palms up. Bring the forehead down to something and take 3 breaths. And then come on up, and we're going to turn our bodies 90 degrees so that we're perpendicular to the mat. We're going to bring our toes together and widen our knees quite a bit. And sit up on your heels. So if there's space between the heels and the hips, put something in there. A blanket might be nice. The next pose is called Tadpole. Our toes are together. This is going to be a stretch of those inner thighs. Remember, that's what we started stretching in our beginning of our practice. We're going to have a block for our chest, maybe 2 blocks. We're going to reach out with our arms, and then we're going to bring our chest or our ribs down to that block. So feel the big stretch on the inner thighs. Make sure it's not a big stretch, that it's just a moderate stretch. And feel the mild stretch on the fronts of your shoulders and feel the lengthening of the back. Let's hold this pose for 2 minutes as well. Remember to use the breath, that long, slow exhalation, to let all the muscles just release and relax. remaining in stillness. How are your inner thighs doing? This is a yin yoga pose that challenges your ability to find a moderate stretch. Sometimes we can go overboard and make this stretch too strong or painful. So learn from this pose. If you haven't been able to relax your inner thighs, don't go quite so deep into the poses. And let's come up slowly and bring our knees together. And sitting off to the side, now we're going to fold forward. We've been tilting the pelvis forward, and now we're going to be rounding the back just a bit. So this will be an opposite position. Sit up nice and tall in the seated staff pose, lengthening the back up. Toes are straight up. We're going to do a pose called half butterfly. In regular yoga, this is called Janu Shirshasana. And it's done with the foot up against the thigh, and we fold over our extended leg. For this pose, let's do a slightly different variation of half butterfly. Let's move the leg out to the side, bring the heel into the groin area if it's comfortable. Now, if your knee is floating, place a block under it because we're stretching that inner thigh. We're also stretching this leg, and you might want to put a little towel or pad under your knee. You don't want to make the stretching too strong. So we're going to be folding forward into the center. We're going to begin by bringing our arms behind us and lengthening the back. We want to hinge at the hips and not round our back. We want to bring the heart forward. So have a bunch of blocks to support whatever you want to rest on. I like to rest on my forehead, and I think of bringing my ribs down into my inner thigh to keep my back flat. So we're going to hold this pose for 2.5 minutes. So choose wisely and take some time to settle into the pose. Reach the heart forward. And at the last minute, you can round the back just a bit. The arms are relaxed and in front of you. Feel the stretch, the stretching sensations, and then manage, change your body so the sensations are just mild to moderate and not strong or painful. When you've settled into your pose, we'll begin the 2.5 minutes and use your breath to let everything go, to relax. Make the exhalation really long and slow. And let's come slowly out of the pose. Extend the back up. Hands behind, lifting the heart, and we'll reach both legs forward. And breathing here. Now you shouldn't feel anything in your knees. If you did, we need to support yourself so the stretch is a little more gentle. That was interesting. I found a little more stretching sensation on the inner thigh and hamstring than when I do the regular version with my legs straight out. So let's move to the other side. Our leg is wide, heel into the groin area. Find the two sits bones rooting into the earth. Lift the spine up, support that knee. Don't let anything be floating or else it just keeps, gravity just keeps making the stretch more intense. Bring the arms behind, lengthen the back. So we don't want to feel this stretch very much in the lower back. Maybe a little, only a gentle stretch, never even a moderate stretch in the lower back. Trying to lengthen the back, bringing our arms forward. We've got our supports for our chest or our forehead. Taking a few moments to settle into the pose. It takes a little while to find that stretching sensation that's just right. Feel the stretching on the back of the leg, the inner thigh, and a mild stretching on the lower back. Let's hold the pose for 2.5 minutes. Relax the arms, long, slow breath. Toes straight up on that extended leg. Remaining in stillness, observe the areas that you're stressing and stretching. See if you were able to relax just a bit. And now let's come on up and we'll straighten that leg, observing the sensations in the knee. Hopefully there's none. Sitting up nice and tall. We're gonna move to our hips now. This, the featured part of this today's practice. We're going to begin in figure 4, but the pose we're really going after is going to be Swan, which is also known as the pigeon pose. In yin yoga, they name the poses differently. Lengthen the back so that you appreciate that the way you do the poses is slightly different than in your regular yoga practice. So let's roll our, come on down to our back. Tilt the pelvis forward. Make that little tunnel under your back. In fact, let's just do some pelvic tilts here. Actually, we were doing a forward fold. So we want to move that lower back very gently. These are like doing mini cat cows, only on our back. So hold that pelvic tilt, that forward tilt, with a slight tunnel under your lower back, if you're able to, and bring one ankle on top of the other thigh, flap the knee away, and then lift that knee or other leg up, press the knee away, relax your neck and lower jaw, and then relax into your figure four stretch. So if you don't like swan or pigeon, as it's also known, you can stay in this pose and hold it for a long time. For the rest of us, we're going to come up to a seated position, sit off to the side, and find our downward facing dog. And from here, we're going to bring that leg that we had put on the ankle. I'm going to start with the right leg and bring it forward. The knee is behind the wrist, the leg, the shin is about a 45 degree angle, the foot is flexed. Slide that back leg back, press the five toenails into the earth, the heel is straight up. Get a block and put it under the hip, so that you're supported and you can hold this pose fairly comfortably. There's no big stretch in the hip. We'll move into our swan pose. Sort of, we're in an upright swan now. Let's go to a sleeping swan by walking the arms forward. You can slide that block back a bit, but don't let there be any space between the hip and the mat. Maybe you can get it all the way down. We're going to hold this pose for 3 minutes. Use your breath to relax, to melt into the mat. Make sure you have supports for your forehead and chest if they don't reach all the way down to the mat. And remaining in stillness, note the stretching sensation in that hip area. Our goal is to make it disappear. And if we can make it just less than when we started, that's a big measure of success. And of course, we'd love to fall asleep because that means we're utterly relaxed. Let's come up to our upright swan. And then we'll just sit off to the side instead of going directly to downward facing dog. Remember, in yin yoga, we stress and stretch our joints quite a bit, so we want to move slowly. And then we'll just roll back onto our back, and we'll do figure four on the other side. Remember to tilt the pelvis forward to keep the back nice and flat, and then lift that foot off the mat, press the knee away with the elbow, both feet are flexed, relax the neck. And if you want to stay here, you're going to be here for quite a while. So enjoy it, relaxing every muscle with the breath. And if you want to try swan, we're back to downward facing dog. Moving slowly. Maybe stretching the legs out a bit. Melting the heart down to the mat. Remember our melting heart pose, that sensation of opening up the fronts of the shoulders. And then we'll bring the other leg forward, knee behind the wrist, shin at a 45 degree angle, the foot is flexed. Slide that back foot back. Point the toes, get a block under your hip. Make sure you can remain here comfortably. On that extended leg, press the five toenails in, get the heel straight up, sit in your upright swan, and let's let that swan go to sleep, bringing the chest down to something, a block, a blanket, or the mat, reaching the arms out, sinking into the pose. Now you can move the block back slightly as you're able to come deeper, but don't leave any space. You only remove it when you can come all the way down to the mat. We'll hold the pose for 3 minutes, relaxing and breathing deep. remaining in stillness, note the quality of the stretching sensation, and then ever so slowly, we'll draw ourselves back up to upright swan, and we'll sit off to the side, drawing the knees up. Let's sit back into child's pose with the hands back by the feet, forehead on something, and just take a couple of breaths. And then coming up to hands and knees for a couple of cat cows, moving with your breath. Let's tuck our toes, do a little toe stretch here. Sit back on the heels. You can put something between the heels and the hips. Then we'll come up, if only if it's comfortable. Manage that stretch in the toes of the back of the feet and make sure it's not too intense. Find your breath and breathe deep and slow. We won't hold this pose too long, but imagine that you could hold it for 3 minutes. And then let's come back to hands and knees, maybe point the toes, wake them up. And then we'll sit back on our heels with our toes pointed, get a couple of blocks. We'll do an ankle stretch, sort of a counter pose in the opposite direction. Make sure this is not too intense. Blocks are back by the hips. And then lift up onto the tops of your feet and give them a stretch. Again, keep the stretch pretty gentle. This is, you can round your back, but it's always good to practice in yoga to try to flatten and lengthen the back. We do this so we can breathe deeply and fully. You can't breathe with a full breath when you're hunched over. Always working on our posture. And then come on down and we'll sit off to the side, extending the legs out in our seated staff pose, Dandasana. We're going to go into a forward fold now. This is called caterpillar pose. So let's hinge forward at the hips. Reach the arms back. Try to keep the back really flat. In yin yoga, there's a lot of rounding of the back, and I like to maybe not do that quite so intensely. You want to feel the stretch in the backs of our legs, not in our lower back. Place your hands on your thigh and lift up as if in a half lift in a sun salutation. Feel the length in the back. Now get some blocks. You can put one between the legs, build up some support for your chest, reach the chest forward. And you, once you're just an inch or two from the block, then you can round the back, bringing your chest or your head or chin down to your support. Reach the arms out with palms up to relax them. Try to bring the lower ribs into the thigh. That tilts the pelvis forward and keeps the back from over-rounding. We'll just hold the pose for 2 minutes. Breathe deep and slow, making sure the stretching sensation in the lower back is very mild. 2 minutes with a long, slow breath. Remaining in stillness, note the stretching sensation in the backs of the legs and the lower back. Our goal is to make them less, not more. That's why we have the blocks, to keep us from sinking deeper into the pose. The only thing that we can do is to relax. Now let's come up very slowly and bring the hands behind. Lift the heart up, lengthening the lower back, stretching the entire spine up through the crown of the head. And we'll come back to hands and knees for a counter pose. So we're going to exhale into the cat, rounding the back upwards. This should feel good because we had a rounded back. As you inhale, tilt the pelvis forward and drop the belly. Do it very carefully. This is the counter pose now. Be very careful. Now exhale into the cat. Inhale into the cow. Let's bring the toes together, widen the knees, reach the arms forward for a very deep extended child's pose, stretching the back, trying to bring the chest and the forehead almost down to the mat. Sort of like an easy tadpole pose. Feel the length in the back as you breathe deep and slow. And then come on up and we'll sit up back into Dandasana. So we're finishing our hip opener with an interesting sequence. This is known in regular yoga as cow face pose, Gomukhasana. But in Yin yoga is called the shoelace pose. So let's start with a long, tall back. We're going to bring one knee over the other for a half shoelace. Now, if your knee doesn't come over the knee, that's no problem. Just put a block under the knee. And maybe eventually you can get it over the knee, but there might be space. So put a block in between that space. Don't let anything float. So from our half cow face pose, we're going to sit up nice and tall. Feel the stretch in the back of the leg and that hip. Nothing in the knee. We never stretch our knees. So when you feel a stretching sensation in the knee, you're doing something wrong. So make changes. Let's bring our arms behind, hinge at the hips, bring our chest down to our knee. Fill that space with a block, and we'll hold the pose for just 1 minute. Reach the arms out and relax into the pose. Keep the toes straight up. And then bring the torso up. Now we're only staying in a minute, but actually we're staying in it for quite a long time because you can remain in this pose and do that forward fold again. Or if you want more and everything feels right, you can bring that extended leg back for the full shoelace pose. If you're in the full shoelace pose, wiggle those two sits bones into the earth. And this takes some time to settle in. Maybe you can sort of wiggle into the pose. Sit up nice and tall. And whether you're in half shoelace or full shoelace, we'll bring our chest forward again using some support. Don't let those two sits bones lift off the block. or the mat. And we're gonna hold this pose for a minute. And then lift the torso up, extend the legs out into Dandasana, shake them out. Remember, we don't want to feel anything in the knees at all. Lift the heart up, our seated back bend, a mild counter pose here. And let's do the other side. I always get confused. I'm so relaxed in yin yoga, I forget which leg I was doing. So remember to support that knee if it's outside of the knee. Try to keep the toes straight up. If they tend to fall one way or another, when you correct, make the correction, note that you're doing a stretch as well. Root those two sits bones into the earth. Make sure there's no space between the knees. Hinge forward, arms behind, nice flat back. Find some space between the chest, or fill that space between the chest and the knee, and relax into the pose for 1 minute. You can bring the arms forward with the palms up, very relaxed. Use your breath to relax. And then lift the torso up, lengthen the spine, stretch that lower back, lift the heart, and choose to whether you want to stay in this pose or go to the full shoelace. Wiggle into the pose, find grounding and steadiness into the earth. Relax and sink into the earth. Lengthen the back, bring the heart forward, fill the space between chest and the knee, and reach the arms forward. Try to keep the sits bones on the earth, don't roll forward, and then we'll breathe into this pose for another minute. And let's come out of the pose. Extend the legs. Hopefully your knees feel great. And sit up nice and tall. And we're starting to wind down our practice. So we'll give our hips and lower back some love. Let's roll back. Actually, let's use our arms to lower back very gently. Walk our feet out to the edge of the mat and let the knees fall in teepee pose. And we'll hug the knees into the chest and bring the knees over the hips. We can rock side to side. You can stir the knees around the hips. The knees are together like stirring a pot of soup. Make sure that you go equally in both directions. Or a third option would be to keep the toes together and bring the knees apart like egg beaters, making circles around the hip joints with the femurs, the upper leg bones. Make sure you go in both directions. Hug the knees into the chest, bring the feet down, walk them out to the edge of the mat again. Back to teepee pose. We're gonna do some gentle twisting here and bring some gentle movement into the hip joints. Bring the knees apart now and let the legs fall off to one side, same side, like a windshield wiper. Exhale, let them come down. Paying attention to that inner knee. Make sure there's no torque or unpleasant sensation in that knee. Don't go too far. Inhale up. Exhale, windshield wiper knees to the other side. We're gazing straight up, lifting the heart up. Inhale, knees up. Exhale, windshield wiper knees to the first side. Don't go too far with that inner knee. Inhale up, windshield wiper knees to the other side. Inhale up, walk the feet together, and then hug the knees into the chest. Exhale, bring the nose of the forehead to the knees, big exhalation, cradle tuck, and then bring the feet down and the head down. Hands by the hips. Extend the legs up. A nice inversion, legs up the wall without a wall. Press the shoulders into the earth. Tilt the pelvis forward so the back is nice and flat. Relax everything now. Just sink into the earth. Maybe pointing the toes and then flexing the ankles. Enjoying, allowing the lymph and vascular fluids to flow back down to the center of the body. Maybe you can circle your feet around the ankle joints in one direction and then the other. Come to stillness, bend the knees, slide the feet out. So the legs are straight, move the heels to the edge of the mat. Cover yourself up for warmth if you like. Bring the arms away from the body. We're moving to our final pose, Savasana. Palms are up. Let's make sure the hips are just right and the shoulders are just right. The neck and the head are relaxed. The chin is relaxed. Take a deep breath. And then exhale it all out. Let control of the breath go.
melt into the mat, relaxing every muscle in the body. Enjoy the peace and serenity of Savasana. I'll be back to get you in 2 minutes. Awakening from Shavasana, bring your attention back to your breath, lengthening and deepening the breath. Bring small awakening movements to fingers and toes. And if you like, stretch your arms overhead, reaching from tips of the fingers to tips of the toes, stretching and letting it all go with a big exhalation. And then when you're ready in your own time, draw the knees to the chest, maybe giving yourself a hug, before rolling over onto the right side, cradling your head with your right arm. Pausing here for a moment in embryo pose for a very long, slow exhalation. Then slowly press yourself back up to your comfortable seat using your yoga gear, your blocks and blankets, finding a sense of grounding, sense of steadiness, find a sense of ease, relaxing and leveling the chin. Let's end by bringing the palms of our hands together, thumbs at the heart in Anjali Mudra. The light within me salutes the light within each of you, the light that connects us all together. Namaste. Well, thank you for coming to Yin Yoga. We've worked our joints in a gentle way, but pretty profoundly. So let's move slowly for the next 30 minutes to allow everything to settle back in before we start any more vigorous movement. So I hope to see you again on the mat for another Yin Yoga practice.